स्टडी ऑफ क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर कोड। टुडे वी डिस्कस द प्रोविजंस रिगार्डिंग कंडीशंस रिक्विजाइट फॉर इनिशिएशन ऑफ प्रोसीडिंग्स एज प्रोवाइडेड इन चैप्टर XIV conditions requisite for initiation of proceedings. This section 190 says cognizance of offences by magistrates. How a magistrate will take cognizance of an offence? You know, cognizance means what? Taking legal notice. Taking legal notice is called cognizance. Subject to the provisions of this chapter, that means subject to other provisions as mentioned in the chapter XIV, any magistrate of the first class and any magistrate of the second class specially empowered in this behalf under subsection 2 may take cognizance of any offence. Cognizance of any offence is there. Who will take? Subject to the provisions of this chapter, any judicial magistrate of the first class and any other magistrate specially empowered to take cognizance in this behalf may take cognizance of any offence. How? On what? Upon receiving a complaint of facts which constitute such offence. First, on receipt of a complaint petition. On complaint petition, on receipt of complaint of facts which constitute offence. Second, upon police report. Third, upon information received from any persons other than a police officer, information received from any person other than a police officer, or upon his own knowledge that such offence has been committed. Section 190 is an important provision. What it provides? Who will take cognizance? Magistrate of the first class. Judicial magistrate of the first class. Any magistrate of the first class, you know, previously it has been defined where the word magistrate without any qualifying word, that will be treated as judicial magistrate. So any magistrate of the first class, that is judicial magistrate of the first class, or any other judicial magistrate specially empowered in this behalf, as per subsection 2, may take cognizance of an offence. First, on receipt of the complaint which constitutes showing the facts, constitutes complaint of facts which constitute such offence. First, on receipt of a complaint petition of the which contain the petition contain the facts which constitute an offence. Second, upon police report. Third, upon any information by any other person other than police officer. What is this? Other than police officer means, suppose a forest officer has filed a complaint petition, the prosecution report, PR, but popularly it is known as a prosecution report, excise officer, on receipt of the complaint, on receipt from any person other than a information, upon receipt of information from any person other than a police officer or on his own knowledge or upon his own knowledge or upon his own knowledge that an offence has been committed. This is cognizance taking. Then subsection 2 provides chief judicial magistrate will empower a second class judicial magistrate to take cognizance of an offence as within his competency to inquiry and trial. What subsection 2 says? The chief judicial magistrate may empower any magistrate of the second class, that is judicial magistrate of the second class, to take cognizance under subsection 1 of such offence. Subsection 1 means in three more. First, on receipt of a complaint petition, which showing of the facts, which show the constitute an offence, upon police report. Third, upon any other on information received by any person other than a police officer, or on his own knowledge that an offence has been committed. So, this chief judicial magistrate may empower his judicial magistrate second class to take cognizance of an offence as per the provisions of subsection 1. But of such offence as are within its competency to inquire into or try. This is section 190. Section 191 says, when a judicial magistrate first class takes cognizance of an offence on his own knowledge, then natural justice demands that he should not try the case. So that's why provision is there in section 191 that if a judicial magistrate first class takes cognizance of an offence on his own knowledge, then prior to taking evidence in the case, he must inform to the accused if he has any objection for trial of the case by that magistrate. If he gives an object, if that accused objects that the case should not be tried by the magistrate who has taken cognizance of the offence on his own knowledge, then in such case, such magistrate will send that case record, case to the chief judicial magistrate for sending this, referring the case or sending the case to any other magistrate for trial. This is the provision section in so in such case, this law requires that he should inform the accused against whom he has taken cognizance of the offence that he has a right that a case be tried to if he objects that the case will be tried by any other magistrate. What provides, you see, when a magistrate takes cognizance of an offence under clause C of subsection 1 of section 190, that is, on his own knowledge, the accuser, before any evidence is taken, be informed. What the accused will be informed? That he is entitled to have the case inquired into or tried by another magistrate. That means he has a right that to inform the magistrate that the case should be tried by any other magistrate. And if the accused or any of the accused, suppose more than one accused persons are there, one of the accused or any of the accused, but objects to further proceedings before the magistrate taking cognizance, objects the further proceeding in the case before the magistrate who has taken cognizance of the offence on his own knowledge, then in such case, the case shall be transferred to such other magistrate as may be specified by the chief judicial magistrate in this law. That means the chief judicial magistrate will be informed by that magistrate for transfer of that case to any other magistrate as per his order. Why? Because if the magistrate takes cognizance of the offence on his own knowledge, then natural justice demands that if the accused objects, he should not try the case. He should not take the further proceeding in the case. He should not take evidence in the case. The case should be tried by any other magistrate. Because if the accused has a right here, because when the court takes cognizance of the offence on his own knowledge, the court's position is in the same position with that of a complainant. So that's why the accused, to for natural justice, that means a person must not be try the case in which he appears to be complainant in any manner. So that's why such a provision is there. Now, section 192, making over of case to magistrate. You know, magistrate takes cognizance of the offence. So can the magistrate try all sorts of offences, all sorts of cases? So that's why this case may be transferred to other magistrate for trial after cognizance has been taken. So here this section 192 provides any chief judicial magistrate may, after taking cognizance of an offence, in the state of Odisha, this cognizance taking magistrate is usually the sub-regional judicial magistrate, and in other outlying stations, the judicial magistrate first class. But in other states, still that is the cognizance taking magistrate in some of the states is the chief judicial magistrate. So that's why it is provided any chief judicial magistrate, after cognizance of the offence has been taken by the magistrate first class, may make over the case for inquiry or trial to any competent magistrate subordinate to him. So any chief judicial magistrate may make over the case for inquiry or trial by any other magistrate, competent magistrate subordinate to him. Then the subsection 2 provides any magistrate of the first class empowered in this behalf by the chief judicial magistrate. If the chief judicial magistrate has empowered a magistrate of the first class to make over a case to other magistrate, in such case, any magistrate of the first class who has been empowered in this behalf by the chief judicial magistrate may, after taking cognizance of the offence, after cognizance is taken by that magistrate, make over the case for inquiry or trial to such other competent magistrate as the chief judicial magistrate may by general special order specify. And thereupon, such magistrate may hold the inquiry or trial. That means, chief judicial magistrate may empower the magistrate first class who has taken cognizance of the offence to make over that case to any other magistrate who is competent to try the case. 193, cognizance of offence by court of sessions. Sometimes a question is put in the main examination of the judicial service that can a session judge take cognizance of the offence. You must be aware of this. When session judge can take cognizance of the offence? Normally the session judge is not competent to take cognizance, because section 190 says magistrate of any judicial magistrate first class will take cognizance of the offence, or a second class judicial magistrate who has been specially empowered by the chief judicial magistrate as per the provisions of section 190 can take cognizance of the offence. But section 193 says, except as otherwise expressly provided by this court or by any other law for the time being in force, no court of session shall take cognizance of offence as a court of original jurisdiction. Section 193 prevents the session judge to take cognizance of the offence expressly provided by the criminal procedure code or by any other law for the time being in force. So if any other law provides that session judge can take cognizance of an offence, then in such case session judge can take cognizance of an offence. Similarly, if there is any other provisions, we have a provisions that is section 197, there we find that is, in such case, the session judge can take cognizance of the offence. In certain cases, that is like defamation, etc., that will prosecution of judges and public servants, that is in section, that is only in section 199 of the CRPC, there is a provision that session judge can take cognizance of an offence when there is a defamation, etc., of the governor, etc. So we'll discuss it later. But section 193 says session judge cannot take cognizance of an offence except expressly provided under the criminal procedure code or under any other law for the timing in force. What it says, except as otherwise expressly provided by this court, if express provision is there somewhere in the criminal procedure code, in such case the session judge can take cognizance, or by any other law for the timing in force, if there is any other law which is timing in force empowers the session judge to take cognizance, excepting in those cases no court of session shall take cognizance of any offence as a court of original jurisdiction unless the case has been committed to it by a magistrate under this code. That means as a court of original jurisdiction the session judge cannot take cognizance of the case, cognizance of the any offence, cognizance of an offence unless the case is committed to him by the court of magistrate. When the magistrate first class commits the case, thereafter the session judge can take cognizance of the offence. Or when there is an express provision in the criminal procedure code that the session judge will take cognizance of the offence, then session judge can take cognizance. Or there is the express provision, there is a provision in any other law that the session judge can take cognizance of an offence, in such case the session judge can take cognizance of it. If a question is put, can a session judge take cognizance of the offence, section 193 provides session judge cannot take cognizance of an offence as a court of original jurisdiction except in the case as provided in the CRPC, in the express provision in the CRPC, or any other law for the time being. But the session judge can take cognizance of the offence once the case is committed to him by the court of judicial magistrate. 194. Additional and assistant judge to try cases made over to them. An additional session judge or assistant session judge shall try such cases as the session judge of the division may by general or special order make over to him for trial, or as the high court may by special order direct him to try. Now question comes, when additional session judge or assistant session judge will try the cases. Additional session judge or assistant session judge shall try such cases as the session judge of the division may, either by general or special order, has made over those cases to him, or the high court has directed the additional session judge or assistant session judge to try that, direct him to try a particular case. Section 195. This section is very, very important. Prosecution for contempt of lawful authority of public servant for offence against public justice and for offences relating to documents given in evidence. Three categories of offences. First, when there is a prosecution for contempt of lawful authority of public servant, first, or for offence against public justice, or for offence relating to documents given in evidence, there is a restriction of taking cognizance of the offence by the magistrate or by the court. What it provides? No court shall take cognizance of any offence punishable under sections 172 to 188, both inclusive of the Indian Penal Code. What is section? That is offenses that is up for contempt of lawful authority of public servant. No court shall take cognizance of the offenses under sections 172 to 188. Both sections inclusive means 172 is to be included and 188 is to be included. Or of any abatement of or attempt to commit such offences. Abatement or attempt to commit such offences, that is offences punishable under sections 172 to 188 of any criminal conspiracy to commit such offences. Three categories: abetment of such offences, attempt to commit such offences, or criminal conspiracy to commit such offences, except on the complaint in writing of the public servant concerned or of some other public servant to whom he is administratively subordinate. That is, offences, so for taking cognizance of offences for contempt of lawful authority of the public servant as provided from section 172 to 188, and for abetment or attempt to commit such offences or criminal conspiracy to commit such offences, no court will take cognizance of those offences unless the complaint is made by the concerned public servant whose order was disobeyed, there was a contempt, or any of the superior officer of that public servant, that is, or a other public servant to whom that public servant is administratively subordinate. So this is section 172 to 18. But unless complaint is made by the concerned public servant whose order was not obeyed, or whose order there was a contempt, against whose order there was a contempt, unless such public servant makes a complaint, or any other superior officer to whom that public servant is subordinate, he makes a complaint, then no court will take cognizance of the offence. Second, then no court shall take cognizance of any offence punishable under any of the following sections of the Indian Penal Code, that is, namely section 193 to 196, both inclusive, 199, 200, 205 to 211, both inclusive, and 228, when such offence is alleged to have been committed in or in relation to any proceeding in any court, or of any offence described in section 463, that is forgery, or punishable under section 471, 475, 476 of the Indian Code, when such offence is alleged to have been committed in respect of a document produced or given in evidence in a proceeding, four documents produced or given in evidence in a court of proceeding in any court, or of any criminal conspiracy to commit or attempt to commit, or the abetment of any offence specified in clause 1 or subclause 2. These are the offences enumerated, except on the complaint in writing of the court. That means these offences are committed against public justice, that is, for offences against public justice. What are those offences? We discussed that as the 193 to 196 of the Indian Penal Code, 199, 200, 205 to 211, and 220 of the Indian Penal Code. Those offences are offences against public justice. So no court shall take cognizance of those offences. Similarly, of punishable or some offences punishable on section 463, that is relating four document produced in court, alleged to have been committed in respect of a document produced or given in evidence in a proceeding of criminal conspiracy to commit or attempt to commit, or the abatement of any offence specified in subclause 1 or subclause 2, except on the complaint in writing of that court or by such officer of the court as the court may authorize in writing in this behalf, or of some other court to which that court is subordinate. This is, you should understand. When, suppose, a person gave false evidence in a court of law, is liable for punishment. In such case, who will be the complainant? That concerned court or any other officer of the court who has been authorized by that court, or any superior court to which that court is subordinate, will make a complaint. In such case, the court will take cognizance of the offence. This is section 195. Now, this subsection 2, where a complaint has been made by a public servant under clause A of subsection 1, any authority to which he is administratively subordinate may order the withdrawal of the complaint and send a copy of such order to the court. That means when a public servant has filed a complaint petition for that is contempt of his order before the court for taking cognizance, in such case his is a person who is to this public servant to whom that public servant is administratively subordinate may pass order for withdrawal of the complaint and send a copy of such order to the court, and upon receipt of that copy of the order no further proceeding shall be taken on the complaint, provided that no such withdrawal shall be ordered if the trial in the court of the first instance has been concluded. Suppose the trial has been concluded on the complaint of that public servant, that offence has been cognizance was taken, but the trial has been completed. In such case, this superior officer of that public servant cannot pass an order that if he passes an order that for withdrawal of the complaint, that will not be given effect. That means, provided that no such withdrawal shall be ordered. Withdrawal order can be passed by whom? By the superior officer to whom that public servant is subordinate. Suppose he passes an order for withdrawal of the complaint petition, which has been filed by the public servant concerned for against contempt of lawful authority of that public servant. In such case, the superior officer may pass an order for withdrawal of the complaint. But if the trial has been completed, then such complaint petition will not be withdrawn. Subsection 3, in clause B of subsection 1, the term court means, what is court? That is court, contempt of, that is public justice, offences affecting public justice, that is court. So in such case, for the purpose of clause, in clause B of subsection 1, the term court means a civil, revenue or criminal court, and includes a tribunal constituted by or under a central, provincial or state act. Revenue, civil or criminal, even includes a tribunal will be treated as a court which has been constituted under a central or state act, if declared by the act to be a court for the purpose of the section. If the tribunal has been declared as a court for the purpose of the section. For the purpose of clause B of subsection 1, what clause B of subsection 1? Clause B says, any offence punishable under for the offence affecting public justice, offence against public justice, that is, for the purpose of clause B of subsection 1, a court shall be deemed to be subordinate to the court to whom the appeal ordinarily lies. That means, by complaint of a superior court, such cognizance can be taken. So who will be superior court? For the purpose of subsection, clause B of subsection 1, here, that means the court to whom a subordinate means, to which appeal ordinarily lies from the appealable decree or sentence or such former court. As in the case of a civil court, from whose decree no appeal ordinarily lies to the principal court having ordinal civil jurisdiction, within whose local jurisdiction such civil court is issued. If it is a civil court, if no appeal lies, then the principal civil court of original civil jurisdiction may make a complaint in alternative of the except court for taking cognizance of the offence. Provide that where appeal lie to more than one court, the appellate court of inferior jurisdiction shall be the court to which such court shall be deemed to be subordinate for the purpose of filing complaint. When the appellate court will be treated as the court to whom that court is subordinate, where appeal lies to more than one court, the appellate court of inferior jurisdiction shall be the court to which such court shall be deemed to be subordinate. Then, where appeal lies to a civil and also to a revenue court, such court shall be deemed to be subordinate to the civil or revenue court according to the nature of the case or proceed. Where appeal lies to civil and also to a revenue court, such court shall be deemed to be subordinate to the civil or revenue court according to the nature of the case or proceeding in connection with which the offence is alleged to have been committed. This is section 195 196, prosecution for offense against the state and for criminal conspiracy to commit such offense, no court shall take cognizance of any offense punishable under chapter 6 or under section 153A, section 295A or subsection 1 or section 500I5 of the Indian Penal Code, or a criminal case to commit such offenses. What are those offenses? 153A. What section 153A provides? Section 153A, that is offense against state, that is 153A, promoting enmity between classes. 153A, no court shall take cognizance of any offense punishable under section under chapter 6 or under section 153A, both 153A, then section 295 also, that is we have, that is promoting religious enmity, 295A, or subsection 1, section 505 of the Indian Penal Code, or a criminal conspiracy to commit such offense, or any such abetment as is described in section 108A of the Indian Penal Code, except to the previous sanction of the central government or the state government. Now section 196 puts a restriction in taking cognizance of an offense under section, under chapter 6. What is that chapter 6? Chapter 6 of the Indian Penal Code, that is waging war or attempt to wage war, chapter 6, from section 121 to 140, that is chapter 6, or section 153A, that is promoting enmity between two, promoting enmity, 153A, that is promoting enmity between classes, promoting enmity between classes in place of worship, then that is section 295A, similarly bringing enmity between two religion, 295A, that is 295A, maliciously insulting the religion or the religious belief of any class, 295A, or criminal conspiracy to commit such offenses, then or any such offense, abetment of such offenses, except with the previous sanction of the state government or the central government, previous sanction of the central government or of the state government. 1A, no court shall take cognizance of any offense punishable under section 153B or subsection 2 of subsection 3 of section 505. 153B, similarly 153B, that is 153B, imputation, assertion, prejudicial to national integration. If that is necessary, offense national integration, then 505B. What is 505B? Having the false statement, rumor, etc., circulation with intent to cause mutiny or offense against the public servant. 505 of the Indian Penal Code, or a criminal conspiracy to commit such offenses, those type of offenses, except with the previous sanction of the central government or the state government or of the district magistrate, of the state government or of the district magistrate. This section 196. Sometimes we skip of this section. No court shall take cognizance on offense under section 153A, that is bringing enmity between two groups, religious feeling, 505 also, that is, that is false statement, rumor, etc., circulated with intent to cause mutiny or offense against the public peace. In such case, or a criminal conspiracy, any such abetment to commit such offense, except with the previous sanction of the central government or state government. Similarly, no court shall take cognizance on offense punishable under 53B, section 505 of the Indian Penal Code, or a criminal conspiracy to commit such offense, except with the previous sanction of the central government . 505 consists of two parts, 505(1) and 500(2). So this is subsection 2 or section 3 of 505. In such case, this is except with the previous sanction of the central government or the state government. No court shall take cognizance of the offense of any criminal conspiracy punishable under section 120B of the Indian Penal Code other than a criminal conspiracy to commit an offense punishable with death, imprisonment for life, or rigorous imprisonment for a term of 2 years or upwards, unless the state government or the district magistrate has consented in writing to the initiation of the proceeding. This subsection, no court shall take cognizance of an offense of any criminal conspiracy punishable under section 120B of the Indian Penal Code other than a criminal conspiracy to commit an offense punishable to death, imprisonment for life, or rigorous imprisonment in a term of 2 years. That means criminal conspiracy which is punishable, criminal conspiracy to commit an offense punishable to death, imprisonment for life, or imprisonment in a term of 2 years, no sanction is required. But for other case, that no court shall take cognizance of the offense, of such offense, or upward, unless the state government or the district magistrate has consented in writing to initiation, consented in writing for initiation of the proceeding. Provided that where the original conspiracy, criminal conspiracy, is one to which the provision of section 190 apply, no such consent shall be necessary. That is, certain category of criminal conspiracy which is punishable, certain criminal conspiracy which is punishable less than 2 years, in such case, the proceeding will not be initiated without the consent of the district magistrate or the state government. Provided, that is, when such criminal conspiracy for committing an offense punishable under section 195 of the IPC, that is, giving or fabricating false evidence with intent to procure conviction and offense punishable with imprisonment for 7 years or upwards. Except in that cases, this provided no such consent shall be necessary. The central government or the state government may, before according sanction under subsection 1, that is giving sanction for prosecution, or subsection 1A, and the district magistrate may, before according sanction under subsection 1A, and the state government or the district magistrate may, before giving consent under subsection 2, order a preliminary investigation by a police officer not below the rank of inspector, in which case such police officer shall have the powers referred to in subsection 1, subsection 3 of section 155. That is, 155, all such provisions, as if that is competent to investigate. That is 155(3) of the CRPC. 155(3). We have already discussed what is 155(3). That is, any police officer receiving such order may exercise the same power in respect of the investigation except the power to arrest. That means when police officer has been directed to investigate a non-conclusive offence, then such police officer will exercise same power in respect of investigation as an officer in charge of police station. This is section 196. We do not that this section 196 is important. Sometimes we skip up the provisions of section 196. 196 is here the sanction of the central government or state government is required for taking cognizance of an offence that is punishable under chapter offence against state. That of bringing offence for bringing enmity between two religion, even to criminal conspiracy to commit such offence or any such abatements of that without the sanction, previous sanction of the central government or the state government, no court shall take cognizance of the offence. Similarly, no court shall take cognizance of any offence punishable under 53B national integration, etc. That is humor. For that, without the sanction previous. Sanction of the central government or the state government. These are the provisions in section 196 of the Criminal Procedure Code. 197, this is prosecution of judges and public servant. Prosecution of judges and public servant. This section is a very big section. 197 is protection to the judges and certain categories of public servant so that they can discharge their duties without any fear and favor. What it says? Prosecution of judges and public servants. Here, this protection is given to the judges and public servants. What protection? That any offense committed, at least to have been committed by such judges or public servants while discharging their duties, should not be cognizance of those, for that, no cognizance should be taken except with the previous sanction of the state government or the central government. So what it says, let us go through the section 197. When any person who is or was a judge or magistrate or a public servant, any person who is, this protection is also available to a person even after his leaving office as a public servant. After his retirement as a judge, what it says? When any person who is or was a judge, either is now continuing as a judge or was a judge, even he has retired or even he is no longer a judge or a magistrate, who is a magistrate or who was a magistrate, similarly, who is a public servant, was a public servant, not removable from his office save by or with the sanction of the government. So first, judge, so far as judge, magistrate, that is different. When any person is or was a judge, is or was a magistrate, or is was a public servant, not removable from service except with the sanction of the government, is an accused. So this section gives protection to the public servant who cannot be removed from service without prior sanction of the government. So to lower categories of public servant, this protection is not available. Only such of the public servant who cannot be removed from his office without prior sanction of the government, then he gets protection under section 197. What it provides? When any person who is or was a judge, who is or was a magistrate, or who is or was a public servant not removable from service without prior sanction of the government, he is accused of any offence, alleged to have been committed by him while acting or perpetrating in the discharge of his official duty. Such was not private in his private capacity. If a judge, magistrate, public servant commits such offence, this protection is not available to him. He cannot avail this protection. Only when such person is accused of an offence purported to have been committed by him while discharging his official duty, or while acting or purporting to act while discharging his public duty, no court shall take cognizance of such offence, save as authorized provided in the Lokapal and Lokayut Act 2013. So now this Lokayut and Lokapal Act 2013, which except shall take cognizance of offence, save as authorized in the Lokapal and Lokayut Act 2013. In the case of a person who is employed, or as in the case maybe was at the time of commission of the alleged offence, employed in collection while the affairs of the union of the central government, in the case of a person who is employed, or as to in the case maybe was at the time of commission of the alleged offence, employed in connection with the affairs of a state or state government. So here, save as authorized provided in the Lokpal and Lokayukta Act 2013, that is, provided that when the alleged offence was committed by a person referred to in clause 1, during the period while a proclamation issued under clause 1 of Article 356 of the Constitution was in force in a state, clause B will apply as if for the expression state government occurring therein, the express central government were substituted. This is a section. Now it has been that there has been this drastic change in this section. That is, that was previously, it was according to the, with the sanction of the state government, such a provision was there. Now it has been provided that no court shall take cognizance of such offence, save as otherwise provided in the Lokapal and Lokayukta Act 2013. Now you have to refer the provisions of this Lokapal and Lokayukta Act 2013 for the purpose of taking cognizance of the offence by a judge or a magistrate or a public servant who is not removable from his service without prior sanction of the state government, without prior sanction of the government, and if he is accused of an offence for committing that offence while discharging his official duty or purporting to act while discharging of his official duty. Thank you. In the next class, we will discuss the provision of section 197 with reference to the Lokapal and Lokayukta Act 2013.